एंड वेलकम टू माय चैनल फिल स्टडी विद टीचर्स। सो आज हम सीखने वाले हैं एनएसओ ग्रेड 5 का चैप्टर नंबर 7 मैटर एंड मटेरियल। अगर आपको फर्स्ट 6 चैप्टर के नीचे तो डिस्क्रिप्शन में दिया है, वहां से जाकर भी देख सकते हैं। तो चलो चैप्टर 7 को सॉल्व करना शुरू करते हैं। सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, रेफर टू द गिवन पिक्चर, हियर एक्स कैन बी डैश। सो व्हाट इज द गर्ल सेइंग? आई थिंक आई शुड कैरी वाई इन अ बॉक्स मेड अप ऑफ एक्स टू माय होम। सो वाई इज दिस सॉलिड आइस and x is the box, and so first option is iron. So iron is a good conductor of heat, so the ice will melt in it, and steel is also a good conductor of heat, so ice will melt in it too. And here c is thermocol, so it is correct because thermocol is a bad conductor of heat, so the ice will stay longer period of time filled in it. Means c option is the correct answer. And now the second question, dash should be used to make a cooking pot and dash can be used to make its handle. So mostly cooking pot का जो ये होता है main, वो aluminium से बनता है, और ये जो होता है handle, वो wood से बनता है, ना कि iron और silver से, क्योंकि iron जो होता है और silver होता है वो गर्म होते हैं, मतलब good conductor of heat, so वो गर्म हो जाएंगे, इसलिए C option is the correct answer. And now let's move to the third question. Select the correct option regarding properties of solid, liquid and gas. So A, solid compressible. So this is incorrect because solid is not compressible, means this is wrong. And B, solid fixed volume. So this is correct, liquid fixed volume. This is also correct. And gas variable volume. So this is also correct. Means about solid, liquid and gas, all are correct. Means B is the correct answer. And now the fourth question. Dash is a universal solvent. So here what are the options? A, water. B, hydrogen peroxide. And C, zinc. And D, ethylene gas. So these three are wrong because water is the only universal solvent. So means A is the correct answer. And now the fifth question. When sugar is added to water, it dissolves to form a solution. Here, A, sugar is a solvent and water is a solute, so this is incorrect. And B, sugar is a solute and water is a solvent. So this is correct, means our B option is the correct answer. And now the sixth question. Which of the following statements is incorrect? A, linen is obtained from plants and absorb water very well. So this is correct because linen is very good in absorbing the water, and it absorbs very fast also. So means this is the correct statement, but we have to find the incorrect one. So B1, plastic conducts electricity very well. So this is incorrect because plastic is a bad conductor of electricity. So B is the incorrect one. And now the seventh question. Select the activity that is an example of chemical change. So A, melting of ice cream. So first of all, chemical change is the change which can be not reversible, and physical change is reversible. So melting of ice cream, so we can freeze it again also, means this is physical change. And B, rusting of iron nails, so this is irreversible, means this is a chemical change. Means this is correct because, and here is D, both B and C also, so we should read the C1 also. Making curd from milk, so this is a chemical change because we cannot make curd again milk. So means our both B and C is the correct answer. Now the eighth question. 5 objects U, V, W, X and Y of the same volume but different masses are put into a tank of water as shown here. So now let's read the question. Which of the following is most likely to be the mass of the object? So this is very easy. Here 75 gram is under the sea and under this water, tank of water, and 52 is up. And means it should be over 52 but less than 75. So in option 35, so it is wrong. 48, it is also wrong. And 64, it is between 75 and 52. and 25 very less, so it will float on the water. So means our 64 gram is the correct answer. And now let's move to the 9th question. Study the given diagram carefully and select the correct option. So here first, A, X solid, Y liquid are heating. So X is solid, this is correct. Y is liquid, this is correct. Why? Because this X is having a, means the molecules are tightly packed to each other, means this is solid. This is liquid because the molecules are lightly far than solids, and this is gas because they are very far in compared to the liquids and solids. Means this is gas. And what are heating? So the gas is changing into water. So gas is changing from gas to water, means it is cooling it. So means this is incorrect. And B, Y gas, Z liquid, T heating. So Y is not gas and Z is not liquid. So means this is also incorrect. And now this even, X solid, Z gas and T freezing. So X is solid, this is correct. Z is gas, this is correct. And T is freezing. So this is correct because the water is changing into ice, that is solid. So means our C option is the correct answer. And now let's move to the 10th question. So here 10, the diagram below shows a pump connected to a glass jar. The volume of the glass jar is 500 cubic centimeters. It is filled with air. When the piston is pushed in completely, 100 cubic centimeter of air is forced into the jar. What is the final volume of air in the jar? So what is the volume of the glass jar? It is 500 cubic centimeter. So it will be the final volume of the air in the jar because air takes the shape of that container. Means our 500 cubic centimeter is the correct answer. And now let's move to the 11th question. A mole has three objects, P, Q and R. He puts P into a measuring cylinder with 30 ml of water. Then he puts Q and R one by one into same measuring cylinder as shown. Which of the following has slash have a volume less than 30 ml? So here this is the P, and what he told, it was 30 ml of water, and now when he put this P, it got 50. Means the volume of P is 20. P is 20, and now here P and Q both, they, at the same time, we know that P is 20 and here Q. So here was also 30, then it got 50, and here what is 75, means it increased by 15, means Q is 15, and now P, Q and R are both, and means we reached till 75 when P and Q were both at the same time. So where is 75? This is 50, this is 60, this is 70, and here is 75. Now it's 80, 90, 100, 110, 120. Means 75, 120 minus 75. So 120 means it is 55. Means it is more than 30, means P and Q only. Because they are less than volume of 20 ml. So P and Q only is the correct answer. And now the 12th question. In the given options, a boy is looking through a material. Which one of the following is represents a translucent material? So this is opaque and this is transparent because he can see through it very easily. The light is passing through it, and opaque, no light is passing through it. And here a little bit of light is passing through it, which is called translucent object. So means this is our correct option. And now the 13th question. Study the given table. So select the option that correctly identifies any two of them. So So here P, waterproof thick means rubber. Yes, rubber is waterproof. And conducts heat? No. So rubber does not conduct heat. This is also correct. And elastic? Yes, rubber is elastic. And now means P is fitting in it. And now this R, copper. So copper is not waterproof, means this is incorrect. And now B1, Q, aluminium. So aluminium is waterproof, that's correct. It conducts heat? No. And it elastic? No. What means? I mean Q is aluminium. So it's waterproof? Correct. Conducts heat? Yes. And it is elastic? No. Means Q is fitting in aluminium and R, wood. So wood, it isn't waterproof. Conducts heat? No. And elastic? No. So means our B option is the correct answer. And now the 14th question. Select the option that correctly gives the examples of physical and chemical change. So as we have discussed, physical change means the change which is reversible and chemical change which is irreversible. So tearing of paper, this is irreversible because we can't stick it again. So means this is incorrect. And burning of paper, so this is also irreversible. We cannot make it paper again. And rusting of iron, so this is also irreversible because we cannot make iron again. And deformation of ice, so this is reversible because if the ice is formed, we can again heat it and make water. So means, and here burning of food, so this is chemical change. Melting of butter, this is physical change. Cooking of food, this is chemical change. And breaking of glass is chemical change. But here this one are wrong, means our D is the correct answer. Now the 15th question. Read the given passage and select the correct option regarding 1 and 2. So 1 has no definite shape but definite volume, whereas 2 has neither definite shape or definite volume. So 1 could be a liquid substance. So here honey and oil are liquid, means the option can be from A or B. And 2 has neither definite shape or nor definite volume. So it doesn't have definite shape and definite volume, means it is a gas. So milk is not a gas, nitrogen is a gas, means A option is the correct answer. And now the achiever section, question number 16. Study the given flowchart given below. So what can be placed as P, Q, R and S? So let's start. So does it break when hit? Yes. Does it allow light to pass through it? No. I mean, first we do the S one. So yes, means it can be spectacle lens. So here is spectacle lens in two options, means the correct option is A or B. And now let's start. So does it break when hit? Yes. Does it allow the light to pass through? No. So here iron rod, it will not break if hit. And ceramic tile, so ceramic tile can break if hit, and it also not allows the light pass through it. Means the correct option is B, but we will read all of it. So here, does it break when hit? No. Can it be stretched? Yes. So it could be rubber, so rubber is here. And can it be stretched? No. P means it is a iron rod. So means our correct option is B. So now let's move to the 17th question. Tanmay has heated a bimetallic strip made up of metal X and metal Y. After a few minutes, he observed that is curled as shown. What can be conducted from this experiment? So here we can see that metal Y has expanded than metal X. So what is correct? Here is written that metal Y expand more than metal X, means our B option is the correct answer. And now the 18th question. Arun perform an experiment to compare the heat conductivity of four different materials P, Q, R and S. Thumb bags were filled with wax on each material, and then materials were fixed to a tube containing hot water as shown in the diagram. Arun tabulated his result as shown here. So what can we infer from this experiment? So here, here R has taken the less time from all of it to melt. So means here metal R is better conductor of heat than material X, because here material S take 4 minutes and material R take only 2 minutes. Means our option is the correct answer. Now the 19th question. Some iron ores were stored in containers for few weeks as shown in the picture below. So only the nails in bottle X rusted. What will be a suitable conclusion for the given experiment? So here here is the X1 is in tap, the nails are in tap water and the bottle is open, so it will rust because rusting requires water and air both. So here C is the correct option. And now the 20th question. Two substances P and Q were filled in a syringe. The plunger was then pushed in as shown in the diagram. Which of the following would most likely be P and Q? So P is pushing very easily, means it could be air, because air can be compressed very easily. So P air means C is correct, but we will read the Q one also. So here Q is water because it is not compressing easily, because water is only slightly compressible. So here means our C option is the correct answer. So friends, अगर आपका वीडियो अच्छा लगा हो तो लाइक, शेयर और सब्सक्राइब जरूर करना. थैंक यू.